Good morning children. In previous class we have started about adverb and also we have discussed about three types of adverb. So today in this class we are going to learn about adverb of number. This is the fourth. So what is adverb of number? Adverb of number is nothing but it is used to show a number. It is used to show a number in a sentence. Like once, twice, secondly, firstly, lastly, never. So these are the adverbs of number. Whenever we are writing a sentence, in that if we use like these words, they will come under the adverb of number. So what is the definition of adverb of number? It is nothing but it is used to show a number in a sentence. It is used to show a number in a sentence. So there are some examples. Firstly, secondly, once, yearly, never, twice, lastly, etc. So these are what? These are the adverbs of number. So let us see the sentences. What is the first sentence I have written? I ate food twice a day. I ate food twice a day. So in this sentence, identify the adverb of number. Which is the adverb of number? Which word is showing for us a number? Twice. Twice is nothing but two times. Twice means nothing but it is two times. So in this sentence, which is adverb of number? Twice is the adverb of number. Twice is the adverb of number. Next, coming to the second sentence. What is the second sentence? He saw me once. He saw me once. In this sentence, which is the adverb of number? Once. Once is the adverb of number. Understood, children? What is meant by adverb of number? Adverb of number means nothing but it is used to show a number. It is used to show a number in a sentence. Okay, children. Now, next we are going to learn about adverb of reason. What is adverb of reason? It is nothing but it is used to show a reason. It is used to show a reason. Examples: therefore, hence, because, so, etc. So these are the some words which will come under the adverbs of reason. What is adverb of reason? It is nothing but it is used to show a reason. So let us see the sentences. It was raining heavily, therefore we stayed in the house. Why we have stayed in the house? Why? Because it was raining heavily. When it will rain heavily, we can go outside? No, we can't go outside. We will stay in our home only. So what is the sentence I have written? It was raining heavily, therefore we stayed in the house. So in this sentence, which is the adverb of reason? Therefore is the adverb of reason. Therefore is the adverb of reason. Next, second sentence. I did not complete my homework because I was suffering from fever. See what second sentence I wrote. I did not complete my homework. Why you have not completed your homework? Because I was suffering from fever. What is the reason? You are suffering from fever. That's why you did not complete your homework. So in this sentence, which is adverb of reason? Because. Because it is showing the reason. Because word is showing for us reason. So that's why it is the adverb of reason. So understood, children, what is meant by adverb of reason? Adverb of reason means nothing but it is used to show a reason. It is used to show a reason. Children, next we are going to learn about interrogative adverbs. So what is interrogative adverbs? Nothing but they are used for asking questions or making inquiries. Interrogative adverbs are used for asking questions or making inquiries. See, how, why, when, what, who, etc. So these are the some words which will come under the interrogative adverb. So let us see the sentences. What is the first sentence I have wrote? How old are you? How old are you? Means asking a question. So it will come under the interrogative adverb. So in this sentence, how is the interrogative adverb? Next, why did he ask you this question? Why did he ask you this question? In this sentence also, why is the interrogative adverb? Next, when do you go to gym? When do you go to gym? So in this sentence, which is interrogative adverb? Why? When is the interrogative adverb? And in this sentence, why is the interrogative adverb? And in this sentence, how is the interrogative adverb? So interrogative adverb means nothing but they are used for asking questions and making inquiries. So these are some sentences and these are some examples which will come under the interrogative adverb. Okay, understood children, everyone, what is adverb and also the kinds of adverbs. So based on this, I am going to give you the worksheet. Everyone should solve that worksheet. Okay children, based on the today's topic and kinds of adverbs, I have given you the worksheet. So what I told total, how many kinds of adverbs I have told total? 6 kinds of adverbs. What are they? Adverb of manner, adverb of place, adverb of time and frequency, adverb of reason, adverb of number, and last one, interrogative adverb. So based on the kinds of adverbs, I have given you the worksheet. So how you have to solve this worksheet? First, read a sentence. First, we have to read the sentence and in that identify which kind of adverb is there. For example, it is adverb of manner means write M in the blank. For example, if it is adverb of time means write T. And adverb of place means write P. Adverb of frequency means write F. Adverb of reason means write R. And interrogative adverb means write I. So like that I have given worksheet. So read out the first sentence what I wrote. Ira often takes the bus to school. Ira often takes the bus to school. In this school means what children? School means nothing but it. One place. It represents what? Place means nothing but adverb of place. So what we have to write in the blank? P. What we have to write in the blank? P. For adverb of place we have to write P. Adverb of time we have to write T. Adverb of frequency we have to write F. Adverb of manner means M. So like that we have to represent in the letters. So read out the sentences carefully and identify which kind of adverb is there in that. We have to identify and we have to write the related letter to that sentence in the space provided. Okay children, everyone should solve the worksheet.